All right, good morning, everyone. Good morning, good morning, good morning, and happy Friday. We are excited because this is the day that the Lord has made, and He has commanded us in His word to rejoice and to be glad in it. Amen. All right, good morning, good morning, good morning. All right, I see me. So I'm going to do what I ask you all to do. I ask you all that you would like the video, that you would stay for our time of fellowship, and that you would share the video. Okay, that you would like the video, that you would stay, and that you would share the video. All right, getting that done. I don't ask you all to do anything that I'm not going to do. All right. All right. So, okay, y'all can hear me clear and everything, I'm assuming. Got everything set up. Hey, good morning and happy Friday. Yeah, we got a happy Friday pom-poms on today. Gonna switch it up with the color. Got a little red and gold on today. So, yeah, happy Friday. We thank God that we have made it. Thank you, Lord, for your faithfulness. Thank you, Lord, for encouraging us. Thank you for the awesome testimonies that are coming through, God, of how you are moving. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord, for all of your many blessings. All of your many blessings. So if you all have your pom-poms, you can grab your pom-poms and you can shake them. All of you previous cheerleaders. Yeah, but we are excited about what God is doing and about what God has done. All right. Good morning. I see you all are coming on in. How is everyone doing? All right. See, Sister Katricia, Sister Ariane, Sister Shemeka, see, PC, good morning, husband, see, Deacon Cliff, see, my Bree, good morning, Bree, say, Minister Tracy, good morning, Minister Tracy, yeah, good morning, and Sister Meredith, 2020, we speak 2020 over her. We thank God for everything God is doing for her and in her and through her. Yeah, good morning, good morning, good morning, as you all are coming in. As I always say, I want to thank you all for your prayers. I thank you for when you share the videos, when you share the polls, just for everything that you do, all of the support that you give. I truly appreciate it. Okay, and we got us a good topic on today. Well, all the topics are good, but this one is a really, really good one. And I find that a lot of times when you teach from something either that you're going through or that you've been through, that can be even more impactful because you know what it is that you are really talking about. You know from experience. You know, I could talk about some things with the Olympics, but I can't talk about it from experience because I'm not an Olympian. But I can say, you know, what I have, you know, observed. But when you talk about something that you know, something that you have experienced, something that, you know, you got a t-shirt and you still, you know, pull that t-shirt out sometimes, you know, been there, done that, went through that, overcame that, you know, still going through that season, whatever the situation may be. So, no, I know this topic on today, what do I do when my back is against the wall? This is a topic that I can truly teach on from my heart. All right. So, yeah. So, good morning. I see Sister Mara is here. Of course, she's here because she's producing and she's directing, too. But I thank God that she's here helping out. All right. Hey, Kiosha. I see Sister Kiosha. I see Sister Neely. We thank God for keeping Sister Neely and her family because you all know she's in Florida. And, you know, Hurricane Debbie came through and she's still on the East Coast, the last that I saw on yesterday. But we thank God for keeping her. Safe, okay, and the God will continue to bless her and keep her safe. Good morning, Brother Jeremiah. Good morning, good to see you. Good morning, good to see you. Jeremiah, be strong in the Lord and in the power of His might. Jeremiah, God never intended when you came to Him for you to have to carry the weight on your shoulder, for you to have to be everything to everyone. No, that's what He is there for. For you to look to Him, for you to stand strong in Him and in His mighty power. Okay? He's there. Sometimes God just wants us to be still and to watch Him move. Okay? Yeah. So you be encouraged, Brother Jeremiah. But I am glad to see you here with us on this morning. I'm glad to see all of you all here on this morning. But sometimes, you know, when you see certain names and you know certain fights that certain members and friends are going through, it makes you feel good. when you see that they're tuning in. So yeah, you be encouraged. You be encouraged. Anytime you know a young man is striving to live for God, the enemy is gonna put up a fight up, and we know the enemy is gonna fight all of us, man, woman, boy, girl, no matter what age. But I'm glad that you're pushing through. All right. Good morning, Mother Lions. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning, all of you all, as you all are coming in. Amen. Come on, y'all. Let's give God some praise. Let's worship him. Let's give him some praise because this is the day that he has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, yeah, Jay, we got you. We got you. We got you. All right. See, Granny Green is coming in. Yeah, God bless you all. God bless you. We are excited about what God is doing. I pray that God will continue to bless us. Mother Granny Green, we speak that you will be encouraged, that you will be strengthened. These past couple of years, they've been difficult. Transitioning from Chicago to Texas is no easy feat. But we know that you are a strong woman and that God has placed a lot in you. And we thank God for what you mean. You mean more to people than what you know. You mean more to our family, you know, to your children, to your grandchildren and everything. So now we thank God for you. And you continue to look to God, Granny Green. Continue to look to him. Continue to pray. Continue to pray. Continue to seek him. Have that special set aside time and seek him. And he will talk to you. He will commune with you. All right. Good morning, Tish. Good morning, girl. All right. Good morning. All right. So we're praying for everyone, that everyone will have a safe commute. Whether your commute is whether you are walking to work, whether you are riding a bike to work, whether you are driving to work, whether you're taking the train to work, however it is that you get to work. If you get up out of your bed and after you get dressed and you go into your office or into another bedroom or into the kitchen or into the living room, and because you're working from home, we pray that God will bless all of us wherever it is that we are, wherever it is that we're working. We're praying that God will protect our children, whether they're at home, whether they're in school, because school has begun for a lot of children. We're praying for the educators and for the admins, that God will give them wisdom for this new school year. We're praying for the children, that they will have a safe and successful school year in the name of Jesus. All right, it's time for college drop-off. So we're praying for all parents who are going to be dropping off their parents, their children, those who have already dropped their children off, that God will bless them to have a smooth transition. A smooth transition. It's not easy trusting your children to be away from you, but you raise them so that they can grow, so that they can stand on their own two feet. And so that, and most of all, we bring them up in the fear and admonition of God. And we know that what we have planted in them will not leave. Okay. So that's, we train them up in the way they should go. And when they get old, they will not depart from it. So Lord, those who are going away, help them not to go away and to lose their mind. Help them to remember who they are and whose they are, God. We're praying for physical and for mental healing, for that, whether you might be dealing with a health challenge or, like I said, a mental health challenge, anxiety, you know, being overwhelmed. Some of us may, you know, we're getting up now, have been dealing with nightmares and different things. No, we speak peace in the name of Jesus. Jesus has given us peace. A lot of times we're asking for peace. He's already given us peace. He's given us peace. And John, I believe it's John chapter 14. He says, you know, let not your heart be untroubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. That means we have control over our emotions. God is already with you. And he said, my peace I have given unto you. Okay. Yeah, so good morning. And we praise God for all of his many blessings. We're also encouraging those who are dealing with grief, that God will heal their hearts, that God will comfort them. And we're praying for those who are in need of financial increase and for those who are in need of favor. All right. And we're also praying for that God protect us at our various places of employment, wherever job sites we may be in, office buildings, medical buildings, wherever we, hospitals, that God will protect us and keep us safe. Even those of us who are, we drive, you know, for a living, that God will protect us and keep us safe. All right. Okay. Good morning, Sister Cynthia. God bless you all the way from Virginia. All right. So we're going to pray. So dear Heavenly Father, Your dear Heavenly Father, in Jesus' mighty, holy, and precious name, Lord, first of all, Lord, we want to tell you thank you, Lord. We thank you, God, for blessing us to live to see another day, God. We thank you, Lord, for life, for health, and for strength, Lord, for the activities of our limbs, Lord. This isn't something we just say, you know, as a mantra. No, this is something that we truly mean, Lord. We thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for healing us. Thank you for keeping us, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord. So many things could have happened, Lord, as we were sleeping, God, but you kept us in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Even those who deal with sleep paralysis and with nightmares and, you know, night terrors and different things like that, I thank you, Lord, that we're overcoming these things in the name of Jesus. Lord, I pray that you'll bless us on today, Lord. Bless us all that have a strong signal, Lord, both in the natural with the Wi-Fi and also in the spirit, Lord, that we will be plugged in to receive from you. I pray, God, you'll bring everything back to my mind and to my memory, Lord, that you would have for me to share with your people, Lord, during this special time with this awesome topic, Lord, that you have given us to talk about on today. I pray, Lord, that they will be encouraged, and I pray, God, that they will walk away filled, F-I-L-L-E-D, that you will walk away filled with what you need on today, whether that be wisdom, whether that be encouragement, whether it could be correction, whatever it is, that you will walk away filled with what you need and with direction for your next steps in the name of Jesus. And even if that direction is to stand still and watch God move, that's what we are going to do in the name of Jesus. I thank you for everything that you've done for us, Lord, for all the prayer requests, Lord, that we have put before you concerning our children, concerning our commute, Lord, concerning healing, concerning finances, concerning favor, Lord, for the new school year, for everything. Lord, you know every need, Lord, and we praise you in advance, Lord, for what you have done and for what you're doing. It's in your name we pray, and for those who are dealing with grief, that you will heal their heart. Thank God. Amen. All right. So once again, remember, first of all, I thank you. Thank you for joining me on today. Thank you for sharing the post. Thank you for praying for me. Thank you for all that you do to make Turn Your Pain Into Power what it is. And next week, you are on, in fact, on Sunday, we turn 1 year old. Sunday, Turn Your Pain Into Power, the platform that God had gave me to birth, and I'm continuing to birth it out. We turn one on Sunday. So we're thankful that, you know, God bless. I didn't quit. You know, I kept going. You know, you get discouraged and different things, but my focus has always been on God and on being obedient to what he has told me to do, because I know what I'm doing is going to be a blueprint for someone else. What I'm doing is going to be, someone else is going to be able to look at me, and they're going to be able to know, you know what, just like she did it, just like she stepped out and did what God gave her to do, I can do it also. Because I have been blessed to look at other women in ministry. And because of me seeing them, it was like, oh, okay. Just like I see them, I know that I can do it also. And we know sometimes you don't see other people doing what God has given you to do. But that means that you are the catalyst. That means you are the one that God has placed the fire under for you to start doing what God has given you to do. So I'm working on a special time of ministry. It's going to be focusing on women in ministry, but of course everyone can join. But I just want to encourage women in ministry to let them know, don't let tradition hinder you. Don't let, you know, odd thoughts and odd reasoning and misteachings, you know, hinder you from going forth and doing what God has given you to do. Since a woman carried the word, who is Jesus, can we not expound on the word of God? Okay, so a woman carried the word. A woman brought the word, who is Jesus, into this earth. So you mean to tell me God can't use women? That women are supposed to be silent? No, we're going to squash all of that. Well, no, because women of God and men of God, what you do is a blueprint for someone else. Okay, so we're going to talk about that. That's coming up soon. All right. But yeah, we'll be celebrating. Like I said, we turn one on Sunday. So next week, we're going to have a party. So we'll see how God have us to do that. Okay, so today we're going to talk about, what do I do when my back is against the wall? And as I said earlier, this is something that I can teach. I mean, I can teach, you know, with my eyes closed, because I have been in this situation before. You know, what do I do when I'm facing fear? What do I do when my faith is faltering? What do I do when my fortitude is being affected? My health is being affected. When my fortitude is failing. What do I do when I have family fallouts? What do I do when there's a financial crisis? Okay. PC said, will there be cash? PC, it's gonna be 7 o'clock in the morning, boo. I don't think we're gonna have cake at 7 o'clock in the morning. Okay, maybe later. Oh, how's it? Maybe you can take me out and we'll celebrate. Turn your pain into power, turning one. How's that? And then we can have cake. Okay. But if we celebrate in the morning, no, we won't have cake. Sister Mar said, coffee cake. So no, we're not gonna do that. Okay, and let me tell you all this too. Because I had heard this earlier this week. You know, I've shared my testimony with different things that I've dealt with. And one of the things that I've dealt with in the past has been like fear, you know, just fear of different things. But what God has shown me is that even though God will bless you to overcome, you know, He has empowered us to overcome. He has given us the strength. He's given us the wisdom. He's given us the blueprint of how to overcome, but there will always be something. I may have overcome fear of public speaking, but then the enemy will try and bring up fear when it comes to coming out of debt. You know what I'm saying? It's like, some people have a fear. They fear where they are financially right now. They fear that they're going to stay, you know, in that situation. They fear that they're not going to come out. They fear that poverty is their portion. But we know that that is not true, because the Bible says in John 10:10 that Jesus said He came that we may have and that we may enjoy our life. And I'm not saying that you can't enjoy your life when you have less than, but how many of you all know it's easier to enjoy your life when you have more? You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying you can't enjoy yourself when money is low. No, because believe me, we have learned, like Paul, we learn how to do stuff when we abase. You know how to, we learn how to be a base. We learn how to abound. We learn how to grocery shop with a list, and you got to stick to that list. And we learn how, I can go in here and I can pick up anything I want. I can put the calculator up on today. So no, we know what it's like to find joy even in the moments of lack, even in the moments of grief, even in the moments of, you know, financial failings, even in the moments of health issues, even in the moments of family fallouts and friendship issues and stuff like that. No, we know, but I also know that it's better on the plus side than it is on the negative side, in my opinion, okay? So like I said, there are always different things that you're going to have to overcome. And like I said, with me, one thing was fear. But I just thank God that, and I want you all to know that when you recognize whatever it is that the enemy tries to hold you back with, because fear will keep you from going forth. You know what I'm saying? If I operate in a fear, I wouldn't be doing what I'm doing now. If I operate in a fear, I wouldn't be, you know, saying what I'm saying now and, you know, writing the book and, you know, going forth and even reaching out to people and ministering to people. I wouldn't be doing that if I allow fear to keep me down. And that's why the enemy sent fear. That's why he sent fear, to try and keep me down. But I thank God for blessing me to realize what was going on and for blessing me to overcome in the name of Jesus. All right. I told you all, dealing with, bitterness, holding grudges, unforgiveness, and the Lord showed me. He was like, no, you have to get that. You're gonna have to get that up out of you. Because first of all, I'm not gonna hear your prayer if you're not forgiving those who have hurt you. So Lord, I was like, okay, Lord, because what is it in Psalm 66:18? If I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. So I had to get myself together because I want God to hear me. Okay, and it's not about being a minister. It's not about being a pastor. It's not about being a pastor's wife. It ain't about none of that. It's about my relationship with God first, my personal relationship with God. I have to make sure that's on point. So I can't be holding grudges and stuff against people. No, I have to forgive, because what I teach, I want to be able to live by it. Okay, what I teach is what I live by. I'm not going to tell you all to do anything that I'm not doing. So I keep my body under subjection. I do what God tells me to do, even when I want to lash out, even when I want to act out in unforgiveness and act out in anger. No, I'm going to walk in the spirit and not in the flesh. Okay, that's what I'm going to do. Okay, so when I find my back against the wall and I'm going through different situations, so I just wanted to share that part with you all to let you know. I don't want you to feel like, when you get into another situation that kind of looks like the same situation, you know, you still kind of feel like that same, like I said, fear, but now instead of fear of going forth, now it's fear with finances, or it's fear with family, or it's fear with confronting someone. No. Just like I overcame the fear in that situation, I'm going to overcome the fear in this situation. Okay. So no, don't fear. Don't feel like, oh, maybe God didn't do it. No, he did it, but you are still overcoming. We overcome every day, people of God. We overcome every day in the name of Jesus. Amen. And like Sister Minister Ella, she said, I choose to walk in the Spirit. And it's a choice, because God is not going to make us. God is not going to make us. PC taught on Wednesday. And he was saying, no, God doesn't pimp us. God doesn't make us serve him. God doesn't make us do anything. God tells us, you know, he has put in his word how he wants us to carry ourselves. And it's up to us to do what he has told us to do. Okay? So, but what do I do when my back is against the wall? What do I do? I mean, when my back is truly against the wall, when I don't know what I'm going to do. You know what I'm saying? When I have been served foreclosure papers. When I go outside and my car is no longer there. Not because somebody stole it, but because it has been what? Repossessed. What do I do when, you know, you find out that someone who, you know, that what do you do when you find out that family members have been talking about you in a bad way? What do you do, you know, when you find out that people who were part of your church have been talking about you and tearing you down? What do you do? What do you do when your back is against the wall? What do you do when you don't have any transportation now? What do you do when you're trying to see, okay, Lord, they about to kick us out? I told you all, this was back in 1998, maybe 1997, and we were living in Lansing, Illinois, in a apartment, and our back was against the wall. Our back was against the wall. My husband, he was working, and he was working hard. He's doing the same thing. He's doing the same thing now that he was doing then. He was taking care of his family. Okay, we had our own business up north also. And we were going forth. He was working and everything. Sometimes he would do different jobs. People wouldn't pay him. Sometimes he would have certain contracts and people didn't want to pay him. Sometimes people would pay him and the check would bounce. So here it is. This is a young man. We were 24, 25. So here it is. We're in this situation. We've already stepped out on faith. Left my parents' house. Took our three children. Moved into this apartment. So, you know, we out here living our life, doing what we have to do, serving God, never left God or anything like that, serving him, you know, staying focused on him, staying focused on the vision, staying focused on ministry, you know, helping people and everything like that. And now here it is, we become behind in our rent, okay? We become behind in our rent. And I don't remember how long, I mean, how long that we were, how far back we were on our rent. And like PC always say, you know, you can judge me if you want to, but at least we kept going. At least we kept trusting God. I can say that we never gave up. We never gave in, even though we wanted to many times. So like I said, you know, I wouldn't be telling my business like that. And that's why people are still stuck. Because ain't nobody sharing what they have truly gone through. But no, I'm going to show you. I'm going to tell you what we have really gone through. Here it is right here. Okay, y'all see that? It says landlord's 5-day notice. Landlord's 5-day notice. So this is what we had. And you know what? Let me see if the date is on here. Yeah, this was February 1998. February the 10th, 1998. So this is a form that they stuck in our door. Because we had not, you know, paid our rent. So, you know, we were like, okay, God, what do we do? We kept living. Every day we kept getting up. PC kept going to work. He kept going out trying to get jobs. He kept working. He kept doing what he had to do. I was at home taking care of the children, you know, teaching them and preparing them for, because they were already in school, you know, helping them. I was doing what I was supposed to do at home. And, you know, I remember one day I was at home with the children and I heard somebody at the door. I knew it wasn't PC because it wasn't time for him to come home. So I heard somebody with a key and they were coming in. And, you know, I went to the door and I opened it. And the man, I believe his name was Bob Boggs. And he was standing there. He was like surprised. He was like, oh, I didn't know that you all were still here. And I was like, yeah, we still here. Because a lot of times when people don't pay their rent, they, you know, they move out at night and stuff like that. No, we didn't have no place to go. I mean, we could have went, you know, back to my mom and my dad's. But no, we were stepping out, doing what we had to do. We were a family. We were adults. We had to do what we had to do. And that meant even facing the hard times. That meant even when our back was against the wall, that we had to stand with one another and we had to continue to trust in God. And that is what we did, you all. Our back was against the wall. PC had to go to housing court and everything. But you all, I'm here to tell you and to testify that when he went to court, they only charged us for the past due rent. They could have charged us like fees. They could have charged us like the court costs and all that stuff. They could have put us out, but they allowed us to stay there and they allowed us to catch up. Do you hear me? Do you hear me? I'm telling you, even in our young days, even when we were growing in our faith, like I said, at that time we were growing, you know, we were still learning and everything. We would hear one person's testimony and we'd be like, oh, maybe we can do that. But it didn't work for us. Why? Because that was their testimony. But I'm here to tell you, I'm here to encourage you on today that God is a keeper. Thank you, Jesus. God is a keeper. Like I said, they could have put us out. They could have had a judgment on our credit. It could have been all kind of different things. But they showed us favor. They didn't have to do that. The young people, the first apartment, they could have put us out. But I'm telling you that God, and you know what? We were honest with them. You know what I'm saying? We would go into the office and, you know, we would tell them, look, you know, I can't pay the rent. You know, I don't have it right now. I only have this. We were honest with them. People of God, all you have is your word. And your word is supposed to be honest. Your word is supposed to be truth. So speak the word and trust in God in the name of Jesus. Okay? Speak the word and trust in God. But here, I'm here. Like I said, me and PC, we have a file folder full of testimonies. And I even want to take them and start putting them in a file so I can read them and everything. You know, I mean, so I can have them so when we go forth, you know, we might want to pull one out because you can't remember everything. But the people of God, I just hear this. Be honest. Be honest. And even if it doesn't work out the way you want it to work out, God will still bless you to have a safe, soft landing. So, yes, I'm here to tell you, we know what it's like to have your back against the wall. We know what it's like, but we have also, thank you, Lord, and that's what I wanted to really hit on this morning. I know what it's like to have my back against the wall, but I also know what it's like for God to bring me through. I have seen God knock walls down. I have seen God come through the wall. I have seen God scale over the wall. I have seen God walk through the wall. I have seen God move for us in miraculous ways in the name of Jesus. And many times, you know, when you go through different things, then condemnation tries to come in. You know, oh, you shouldn't have did this. And, you know, y'all was young getting married. You know, we was 19 getting married, 20 having our first child, 21 having our second one, 23 having our third. And, you know, the enemy will come in with condemnation. Y'all putting these children through this and, you know, you putting your wife through this and you know, you out here trying to do a business and people not doing you right. You need to let them know how you feel. You need to be cussing people out. But no, we chose to maintain our salvation. We chose to remain our stance of faith and to be the man and the woman and the children of God that God has called for us to be. And we see how God has moved and how he is moving for us. And let me tell you all, our back still gets put against the wall even now. Even now, after being married 33 years, even now, after being saved, you know, over PC got saved he been saved 34 years. Excuse me. I got saved when I was 10. Okay. So, you know, even after being saved all this time walking with God, I'm telling you, you are going to face trials. Your back is going to be against the wall, but I encourage you to stand strong. I encourage you to stand sure. Be sure. Be sure of who you're serving. Because when you're sure of who you're serving, you're going to trust in him and he's going to bring you through in the name of Jesus. So I'm here to tell you also that there is no condemnation. God does not hold my sins. He does not hold my transgressions. He does not hold my, check this out, my disobedience. He does not hold my missteps over my head. No, he does not do that. He does not hold things over my head. Just like I don't condemn my children, I don't condemn Vision Life Center members. I don't condemn other people. So since I don't condemn other people, since I don't condemn my children when they mess up, why in the world would God turn around and condemn me? No, he does not condemn me. Because the Bible says in Romans 8:1-2, Paul says, therefore, there is now no condemnation, no guilty verdict, no punishment for those who are in Christ Jesus, who believe in him as personal Lord and Savior. You hear me? For the law of the spirit of life, which is in Christ Jesus, the law of our new being, has set you free from the law of sin and death. I am no longer subject to be judged by what I have done. Why? Because I have accepted Jesus as my personal Savior. I have accepted his sacrifice that he made. And when I do sin, when I do fall short, what do? I repent. I repent. I say, Lord, forgive me. I know as it says in 1 John, what is John? Oh, 1 John 1 and 9, I believe, how it says that he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins when we repent. So no, Lord, please forgive me. Forgive me for falling short. Forgive me for being disobedient. Because when I step outside of God's will, I know what I'm doing. It ain't like a surprise. It ain't like I'm walking around, surprise, surprise. No, ain't no surprise. No, I know that I have not done what God has wanted me to do. Lord, forgive me. And I thank you, Lord, that I'm no longer guilty. Because the Bible says, he who comes to God, that he's a new creature. It says old things have passed away. Behold, all things have become new. So God is not condemning us. God is not concerned about the murders that we have done. God is not concerned about the drugs that we have sold. God is not concerned about the people that we have torn down by our mouth. God is not concerned about the character assassination that we have put out on somebody else. God is not concerned about that. All of that has been thrown into the sea of forgiveness because I had accepted him as my personal Savior. Okay. So the law of the, so now the spirit of life that is in Jesus, that's what's in me. Okay? No condemnation. Okay? So that's what I do. And then so I remind myself, people of God, and you all, not only do you have to remind yourself, you have to rehearse. You have to rehearse telling yourself that I've been engineered for this. I remind myself of God's faithfulness. I remind myself that God has brought me through in the past. That's why we keep these testimonies, so we can remember what God has done. When you're going through a tough situation, no, just roll back and remember what God has done. Just take a quick look back and remember, oh God, I've been in tougher situations than this. I remember when someone was trying to take my life. I remember when I was out killing people. I was taking people's lives. I remember when I was outside of your will. I remember when I knew better, but I didn't do better. I remember all of this, but what did God do? He has brought me through. He gave me enough time to get myself right. And for that, Lord, I thank you, God. Hallelujah. I thank you, God, for giving us enough time, God, to get it right in the name of Jesus. So I rehearse. You know what? Just like you can rehearse the sins that you have done, just like you can rehearse worry, just like you can rehearse a bad health challenge, just like you can rehearse the accident that you had, just like you can rehearse the abortions that you have had, just like you can rehearse how you broke a promise to God, you can rehearse and you can remember and you make yourself repeat what God has done. I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. I am fully loved by the Father. I thank you, Lord, that I am the head and not the tail. I thank you, Lord, that you are preparing a table before me in the name of Jesus. That you are preparing a table before my enemies in the name of Jesus. I thank you, Lord, that you are my shepherd and I shall not want. I thank you, Lord, that you are a strong tower that I can run into and I can be safe. This is what I remind myself of. Now, forget, stop repeating, stop rehearsing all the sins that you have done, all the transgressions that you have done, all the times that you have stepped outside of God's will, all the times that you have not been financially responsible, all the times that you have not been responsible over your body, over your mind, over your soul, over your spirit. No, stop rehearsing that and instead rehearse about the goodness of God and the grace of God and the mercy of God. Lord, we are thankful, Lord, because your mercies are new every morning, God, in the name of Jesus. Great is your faithfulness. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hands have provided. Who need God to do something for you on today? Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. After thyroid surgery, great is thy faithfulness. Don't need no meds. Lord, unto me. This is what you got. You got to remember. Hallelujah. You got to remember. You got to remember. Ain't no sin in remembering. You don't. I didn't say you stay in and stay stuck in sin. I don't say you stay stuck in the bad times. But no, you remember, and then you rehearse what God has done. You repeat what God has done, and you have to make yourself. You have to train yourself to think on the goodness of God, because it's always easy to think about the bad. It's always easy to think about those who have hurt us. It's always easy to think about when we have hurt other people. But now, sometimes you got to take a step back, and you just got to remember about the faithfulness of God. Lord, I thank you. I thank you, God, in the name of Jesus. I thank you, God, for saving, for healing, for delivering. Lord, I thank you. Our parents may not be here with us. Some of us, our parents have passed on. Some of us, our children have passed away. Some of us, we've lost people. I mean, people who are close to us have passed away. But Lord, you have still shown your faithfulness to us, Lord. And for that, God, we are thankful and we are grateful, because we've seen your hand. That's why I have to remind myself. I have to remind myself. I have to remind myself. I have to rehearse it. I have to repeat the goodness of God. I have to, because the enemy is always trying to come in. I told you all back in 2019. Now here it is. I had a testimony from 1998. Now I'm in 2019, and we were going through some tough situations financially. I'm trying to rebound, trying to recoup. You know, believing God that we were going to recover, that he was going to restore us in the name of Jesus. And we've been rehearsing this, and we've been declaring it, but we weren't seeing it yet. We've been rehearsing it. We've been declaring it, and we've been decreeing it, but we weren't seeing it yet. And the enemy was saying, God doesn't love you. Look at that. You've given all your life to him. You served him since a child. Look at that. Your husband came in here, and he accepted Jesus as his personal savior as a young man at the age of 18. He could have been out there doing whatever he wanted to do. He could have been stacking money. He could have been doing this. You could have been out here living your life. You could have experienced what it was like to, you know what a drink tastes like, and to know what this is like. And but what did y'all do? But y'all said, no, I'm going to serve God. No, I'm going to be faithful to God. And now look at you. Look at you. You serving a God who doesn't love you. You serving a God who has abandoned you. You serving a God who, here it is, your back is against the wall, and you don't know what you're going to do. And look at you. Look at you. Look at you. Just look at you. Look at the people who have left your life. Look at the people who have rejected you. Look at the people who have abandoned you. Then the enemy start with those fiery darts. Huh? Maybe what people said was true. Maybe we shouldn't have gotten married when we was 19. Maybe we shouldn't have did this. Maybe we shouldn't have moved. Maybe we shouldn't have started a business. Maybe, no. I had to take control of my thoughts, and I had to make myself rehearse and repeat, and I had to remind myself about the goodness of God. So what did I do? I took post-it notes. This is one of the post-it notes, the original post-it notes that I had. And you see it says, God is good. I put the date. This was on September 2019. Put the date on it, because I want to remember. I want to remember when the enemy thought that he was going to have me to turn my back on my God. I want to remember when the enemy thought that I was going to leave God and go back to serving him. I wanted to remember. This is a bookmark. Hallelujah. This is a bookmark. This is a bookmark where we just had to pause, and we had to stand still, and we had to so wait for God to move and to watch him move. I took these post-its. I put them up in the living room. I put the post-it. I put one over the sink. I put one in our bedroom. I put one in our bathroom. I put one in the other bathroom. I put one on the door. So when you were going out, that's what you would see on the door. And then when you turn around and you close the door and you come in, you would see it on the door. I reminded myself, because it said that God is good. The enemy was telling me another thing, but I had to rehearse, and I had to remind myself, and I had to repeat that, no, my God is good. No, my God is good. No, God loves me. He loves me with an unconditional love. No, he sent his only son Jesus to die for me. He would not have sent someone to die for me if I was not worth dying for. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. This is what we do when our back is against the wall. We trust God. We repeat. We rehearse. We remind ourselves. I tell myself, if I'm in it, that means I've already been engineered to handle it. If I'm in it, I've already been engineered to handle. I have everything in me. Say this. I have everything in me to make it through my present situation. I have everything in me to make it through my present condition. Come on, say that. I have been engineered for this. Say that. I have been engineered for this. Okay? What I'm going through now is not a surprise to God. It's not a surprise to God. So if it ain't a surprise to God, what am I going to do? I'm going to rest in Him. I'm going to lean back and I'm going to rest in Him. I'm going to cast all of my cares on Him, as it says in 1 Peter 5 and 7. I'm going to do what Isaiah 26 and 3 says. It says He'll keep those in perfect peace whose mind is what stayed on Him. Excuse me. That's what I'm going to do. I've been engineered for this. And if, since I'm in it, I know that I'm going to make it out of it in the name of Jesus. Yes, my back is against the wall. Yes, I don't know. It's a bill collector at the door. Is family issues at the window? Is health issues, you know, over my head in the ceiling? I'm surrounded by issues. But they don't know, as it says in Psalm 91, that I can dwell under the shadow of the Almighty. And then it's a song they say, you know, this is how I fight my battles. They say, it may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Yeah, I got bills. Uh-huh. I got bills. I got family issues. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. We dealing with this. It may look like I'm surrounded, but I'm surrounded by you, God, in the name of Jesus. My back is against the wall, but I'm going to trust in you, God. I am trusting in you. Since I'm in it, God is going to bring me out of it. It says in 1 Corinthians 10:13, it says, no temptation, regardless of its source, has overtaken or enticed you that is not common to human experience, nor is any temptation unusual or beyond human resistance. But God is faithful to His word. And let me tell you, let me take a pause here. I hear Holy Spirit. Let me take a pause here. Don't look at the dates of the things that I'm telling you and be like, oh, but that was a long time ago. The Bible was written a long time ago, but it's here to encourage us. So don't allow the enemy to speak any lies into your head. Because I can tell you some testimony. God is, check this out. God is forging a testimony now in 2024. He's forging a testimony in us now that you will hear about. But no, you take these testimonies and you know the same pain that we felt back then may be the same pain that you're feeling right now. But I'm telling you that God will bring you through because He brought me through in the name of Jesus. I know what it's like to be depressed. I know what it's like to be stuck. I know what it's like to be wondering if you made the right choices. I know what it's like to regret things. But I also know what it's like to turn to God. I also know what it's like to repeat and to rehearse and to remind myself about what God has done in the name of Jesus. And He told me in 1 Corinthians 10:13 that nothing that I'm dealing with is beyond human experience. Somebody else has gone through what I'm going through, and somebody else is going through it in the name of Jesus. Okay? Somebody else has gone through what I'm going through, and somebody is going through it in the name of Jesus. That's why me and PC will continue to tell our testimony. Even if we the one who put us in the thing, even if it was a self, it's because of self. It wasn't sovereign. It wasn't satanic. It wasn't a sign of that. No, it was self. Even with that, I'm here to declare unto you, God will deliver you out of situations that you get your own self in the name of Jesus. If you just turn to Him. Many times we stay stuck because we don't turn to Him. We're trying to figure it out ourselves. I got myself in it. I'm going to get myself out. How's that working out for you? No, turn to Him because He is the one who delivers us. The Bible says He's a very present help in our time of trouble. The Bible says He perfects all that concerns us. That He heals our broken heart in the name of... You can't heal yourself. You can't heal your heart. You need God to do that in the name of Jesus. Okay? So there's no temptation unusual or beyond human resistance. But God is faithful to His word. He is compassionate and trustworthy. He will not let you... Hear me, people of God. He will not let you be tempted beyond your ability to resist it. Okay? He will not let you be tempted beyond your ability to resist it. So you ain't got to say, well, I just had to give in. No, you didn't. No, you have the strength in you to stand in the name of Jesus. It says, but along with the temptation, He has in the past and is now and will always provide the way out as well, so that you will be able to endure it without yielding and will overcome temptation with joy. A way of escape has already been made, people of God. You just have to ask God where it is and how do I get out of here. My back is against the wall, but Lord, I believe you can bust through this wall. I believe you can open the door. I believe you will open a window. I believe you will do something supernatural and you will deliver me out of this situation. And the wall will no longer be behind me in the name of Jesus. Okay? We trust God and we believe God in the name of Jesus. We don't get stuck in what we're going through. So people of God, what are you going to do with your wall? What are you going to do with the wall? What are you going to do when your back is against the wall? What are you going to do? You got your hands up. You said, Lord, I have surrendered all, God. I don't know what to do. Jehoshaphat, they said, was it 2 Chronicles, was it 20? Well, they said, Lord, we don't know what to do, but we look to you. They were surrounded by their enemies. They were about to be taken out. So what Jehoshaphat, King Jehoshaphat said, you know what? I'm about to call a fast. We about to see God. We about to see God. And me and Pip, we've been fasting, you know, this week, Lord, because we need to move from you. Sometimes you got to turn that plate over. And he said that he had everybody, the children was fasting. I think even the animals was everybody was fasting. They said, he said, and they said, Lord, we don't know what to do, but we look to you. What did God do? God moved in a miraculous way. King Jehoshaphat, God sent a word. And God said he can't. God sent a word. And they said, you have no need to fight this battle. They said, when you go on tomorrow, they said, send Judah first. What is Judah? Judah's praise. Send Judah first. And what did God do? God, they sent Judah first. When they got there, their enemies were confused. They attacked one another. Jehoshaphat and they didn't have to even attack anyone or anything, but they were able to go in and get all the good stuff that the people who were coming against them left, all the spoil. And if I remember correctly, it took them 3 days to collect all the spoil. When they say spoil, they mean like they left all their stuff. They left their cell phones. You know what I'm saying? I'm talking about these days. They left their cell phones. They left car keys. They left cars. You know what I'm saying? They left house keys. They left everything there. And Jehoshaphat, and they were able to go. It took them 3 days to collect all that their enemies had left there. I'm here to tell you, when you seek God, God will move for you in miraculous ways. It's not always going to be someone giving you a check. It's not always going to be someone coming to your door. It's not always going to be someone giving you a hug. No, God will supernaturally move for you in the name of Jesus. God will cause people to be a blessing to you. God will cause food to show up. God will cause money to show up in your account. God will cause food to show up to your home. God will cause a new program to be birthed. They thought they was birthing a program for someone else. They thought that they were constructing a program for someone else, but they didn't know that God had you in mind. That God had you in mind when they had that you know, different income programs, you know, where they were able to take different payments and put them on the back, where they were able to cancel out on payments, where they were able to allow you to get into forbearance, different things like that. Lord, I thank you for whatever it is that you can do during this time, just so I can breathe, and I can get my bearings straight. So I know where I am. I was driving yesterday. I was talking to PC. I was like, wait a minute. I said, hold on. I got to get my bearings straight. I got to see where I am. And God will allow you to breathe and he will show you what your next step is. And sometimes it's not a step, you all. Sometimes it's being still. It's being still. In Psalm 46, 10 through 11, it says, be still and know. Recognize and understand that I am God. I will be exalted among the nations. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our stronghold, our refuge, our high tower. This is what we do. It says, be still and know. Check this out. In Psalm 46 and 10, and somebody needs to hear this morning. Psalm 46 and 10 in the contemporary English version, our God says, calm down. Okay? This is the contemporary English version of the one I just read about the be still and know. It says, calm down and learn that I am God. You hear me? People of God, we have to learn how to trust God. People of God, we have to learn. That's why I said earlier, you have to make yourself, you have to rehearse. You have to practice. You have to remind yourself. You have to repeat about what God has already taught you in the past. You have to teach yourself. See, because, and this is some of my message for Sunday, because the enemy, The world goes by certain standards. The enemy, the world wants our mindset to be conformed to the world's way of things. You know, when things are going good, then you're happy. Things are bad, you can be sad. Now, what do we do? No, in everything, we give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus. I didn't say for everything, I said in everything. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not to thine own understanding. In all your ways acknowledge him, and he will do what? He will direct your path. My back is against the wall, so what am I going to do? I'm trusting in God in the name of Jesus. It says, calm down and learn that I am God. You know, sometimes God has to, he has to teach us. He has to learn us. He allows us to get into situations where we have to trust in him without a doubt. And like I said, many of us, our back is against the wall right now. But we are going to trust in him because he's already told us to be still and know that he is God. And since he is God, I'm trusting in him that he's going to show up in a special, specific way just for you in the name of Jesus. You hear me? He's going to show up in a special, in a specific way, in a supernatural way just for you. Some of you I have been asking for specific things. God is going to show up in a special, specific, supernatural way just for you. Where you're going to walk around, you're going to say, I know this is God. I know this is God. I ain't told nobody. Because many of us, what we're in, nobody else can get us out of. No one else can. We can't call on our dad. We can't call on our mom. We can't borrow no money from our children. We can't go to the church. No, many things that we're dealing with right now, our back is against the wall, and we have to trust God in the name of Jesus. And everything isn't finances. Some things are family. Some of us are family. We are brokenhearted concerning family situations. Some of us it's health issues. Some of us it's our faith. We just don't feel strong in the Lord like we used to. And we feel guilty about that. The devil is a lie. We already said there is therefore now no condemnation. We talked about that already in Romans 8? Romans 8? There's therefore now no condemnation. Yeah, Romans 8. No. We're not going backwards. We're going forward in the name of Jesus. Okay, so before we get off, we got 9 minutes. I really hope that you all are being blessed by this and that you all are encouraged. What do I do when I don't see my next step or when my life is in a holding pattern? What is a holding pattern? A holding pattern is a state or period of no progress or change. And many of us, that's where we are in the name of Jesus. That's where many of us are. We are in a holding pattern. When a plane is in a holding pattern, it's not going nowhere. It's not landing. It's not taking off. It's in a holding pattern. It is in a state or period of no progress or change. But I am here to tell you people of God that it only takes God one move to get you out of that holding pattern that you're in. Your yes is coming. Your yes is coming. Your contracts are coming. Your keys are coming. Okay? And I don't mean coming like far. No, we decree and we declare that it is done in the name of Jesus. Okay? Your apartment. I had something with housing. Somebody's looking for some housing. Housing, land, apartment, townhouse, mortgage, rental, rent to own. God said that he's working things out for your good in the name of Jesus. He's saying, stay faithful to me. And if you're not faithful, get faithful. Because many are asking God for different things, but they're not doing what he has asked of us. Come on, Holy Spirit. We're asking God for things, but we're not doing what God has asked of us. And yes, part of what God asked us to do is to give. Yeah, give and it shall be given unto you. Yes. Yes, giving. Yeah, there they go talking about money. Yes, that's right. That's right. Yep. Yes. We have to give. And we also have to live a godly lifestyle in the name of Jesus. Okay? That's what we have to do, and we have to be in faith. And you all, when it comes to faith, you have to be like the Father in Mark chapter 7. He said, Lord, I believe, help thou my unbelief. So if you feel like your faith is faltering, that's when you do what? You saturate your mind with the Word of God. You turn the Word of God on. I've been listening to the Word for the past month, and I just don't feel like I'm getting anything. It's not about your feelings, boo. It's not about, you are building up your spirit, man. You pick up stuff, even when you don't know that you're really, you know, taking it in. That's why I said when you're taking a shower, when you're cooking, if you're in a job where you can listen to the Word, keep the Word on and keep the Word flowing. You're tearing down the lies of the enemy, even though you don't see it. You're building up barriers to the enemy, even though you don't see it. What are you doing? You're building up your faith, because faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Our faith is built up when we hear the word of God. That's why many of us, our faith is faltering, because we're not hearing the word of God. We're not taking it in. We're not going to church. We're not listening to the word. We come to church, and then we don't go back home. We don't listen to the message again. We have so many ways we can hear the word of God now. Back when I was coming up, we didn't have all that. If you had to get a CD, if you went to church and you missed the sermon, you just missed the sermon. You missed a sermon. Because back then, they did not have CD and tapes, and you know, but they were making it. Then that came along. But every church didn't have that. So you have to, there are so many opportunities for us to get the word. So many opportunities for us to listen to the word. You can listen to YouTube and you can still work on your phone. There's so many opportunities. Don't miss out, you all, on saturating your mind with the word of God. That's how we overcome with the word of God and with faith. And this is the victory that overcomes the world, even our faith. Okay? Jamaica said, yes, when I get ready to complain, I'll start singing. Amen. And what you're doing is you putting up a shield. Come on, I'm getting into my message on Sunday. You putting up a shield against the fiery darts that the enemy is shooting at you, telling you, go ahead and complain. Look, you've been serving God all this time. To Jamaica, you done made cakes for people. You done served God. You've been serving PC, you know, for years. And you know, God has you what? In a holding pattern. Since God has me in a holding pattern, thank you, Jesus. I know he's holding me. I know he's protecting me. I know he's covering me. I know he's guiding me. So yes, I may be in a holding pattern right now. My life may not be going where I want it to be going right now. I may feel like I'm in a state or a period of no progress or no change. But I tell you what, I ain't gonna do, devil. I ain't going back, I tell you that. Okay, I ain't going back, I tell you that. I stay in a holding pattern till Jesus come back and get me. I tell you what, I ain't going back in the name of Jesus. I'm not coming back to serve you again in the name of Jesus. I tell you that. I tell you that in the name of Jesus. Okay, I tell you that. The devil is a lie. Psalm 91. Psalm 91. I'm dwelling under the shadow of the Almighty. No, we're not going to be hell. I ain't going back. I might be in a holding pattern. I ain't scared. We ain't never scared. I ain't scared. You know the stuff we've been through? You know the stuff that we... Do you know the attacks that we've gone through, that we have endured on marriage, on family, on ministry, all the fiery darts on ourselves, self-esteem and stuff? You think I'm going back? The devil is a lie. I'm trusting in God. Psalm 91, he that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide... under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say of the Lord, he is my refuge and my fortress, my God, and him will I trust. Hallelujah. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shalt thou trust. His truth shall be thy shield and thy buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flies by day. You hear that? You hear that, people of God? So you don't have to worry about what's going on in the morning. You don't have to worry about what's going on at night. God is covering you at all times in the name of Jesus. No, I ain't going back. I'm not moved by what I see. I'm moved by what the word of God says in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It says in Psalm 121, in the message version, it says, I will look up to the mountains. Does my strength come from mountains? No, my strength comes from God, who made heaven and earth and mountains. He won't let you stumble. Your guardian God won't fall asleep. Then it says in 5, it said, God's your guardian, right at your side to protect you, shielding you from sunstroke, sheltering you from moonstroke. In other words, God is covering me 24 hours a day, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, however many days it is in a month, 365 days in a year. God is covering me in the name of Jesus. I'm not moved by, you know, the attacks from the enemy. Yes, it's irritating. Yes, it's frustrating. Yes, it can be disappointing. Yes, it is. Nobody wants to be in a holding pattern, but I know sooner or later that God is going to allow me to land, and it's going to be a soft landing, it's going to be a safe landing, and he's going to bring me through in the name of Jesus. So people of God, what are you going to do? We got 2 minutes. What are you going to do with your wall? What are you going to do with your wall? Are you going to weep on it, or are you going to allow it to make you stronger? You hear me? What are you going to do with your wall? Your back is against the wall. What are you going to do with that wall? Are you going to weep on it? You know, sometimes you see people and they're leaning, you know, against something and they cry. Are you going to lean against your wall? Or, you know, sometimes, you know, we work out with Deacon Rail, and he would have us doing standing push-ups. So you would place your hands firmly on the wall and you would do your push-up. You would do your push-up. You would do your push-up. And some people might be like, well, that's not the same as being on the floor. I'll do it about 50 times to see if you still think the same thing. So are you going to allow the wall to be a place where you weep? And don't get me wrong, there's nothing wrong with weeping. The Bible says weeping may endure for a night, but your joy is going to come in the morning. The Bible said that God is bottling up all of our tears. The Bible says what you sow in tears that you're going to reap in joy. But what I'm saying is after we get to the point where we've exhausted all measures, we've been diligent, we've been disciplined, we've done all that we can do, we've been rehearsing, we've been repeating, we've been remembering, we've been practicing, you know, reminding ourselves God's word and what he said. After that, what are we going to do with that wall? Are we all going to allow it to be our weeping and wailing wall? Are we going to allow it to make us stronger? Are we going to allow it to build up our faith? Are we going to allow it to help us to be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power? That's what we're going to do. Okay, that's what we're going to do. Like PC said, we can even scale the wall. Scale, you can go over the wall. There's going to be a way of escape that God is going to make for us in the name of Jesus. People of God, I pray that you have been blessed today. I love this message of something that God gave. And I told you, yeah, some messages that we, especially when we have lived it. And when I say live it, that don't mean that it has been easy. Oh, but when we have lived it and when we have overcome it, and we're still overcoming it. I love delivering messages like this because I teach it from conviction because I know what God has done. I know what God has done. So I pray God will bless you. Many of y'all, you're getting ready to go check in. You clock in for work. I pray you'll have a blessed day. I've already prayed for your protection. I pray for wisdom. I pray for knowledge. I pray the work will become easy. I pray that God will give you witty ideas of how to get things done. I pray for favor in the name of Jesus. For those who are looking for employment, I pray that your application, put the applications in. I pray that your application will rise to the top and get into the hands of the one that God wants it to go to in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will place you where he wants you to be, that you will get into your wealthy place. You go through the fire, you go through the water, unemployment, bills backing up, back against the wall. But now God is about to do what? He's about to bring you into a wealthy place. And God says, when you get there, God says, when you get there, don't forget about him. But God is also saying, even as you're going through it, don't forget about him. Even as you're going through it, don't forget about him. Don't wait until the end to praise him. No, the Bible says, in everything give thanks. The Bible says, I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. People of God, be encouraged. If you don't know Jesus as your personal Savior, I pray, I encourage you, I implore you, I beseech you that you would accept him as your personal Savior, because that is what's going to help you to get over your wall. It says, Father, I know without Jesus that I'm lost. I believe your word that says you sent your only son, Jesus, to die on the cross, and he rose again just for me. Father, fill me with your spirit and with your power so that I may live a life that is pleasing to you. Thank you, Lord, for saving me. Thank you, Lord, for filling me with Holy Spirit. I thank you, Father, that I am now a part of the family of God from this day forward. In Jesus' name, amen. Welcome to the family of God, people of God. Like I said earlier, don't try and figure stuff out on your own. Don't try and get yourself right before you come to God. It's like getting yourself right before you come to God is like you fix a dinner even though Chef Toya is coming over to fix dinner for you. Why are you trying to do something that he's going to, come on, Holy Spirit, that he's going to do for you? You can't get yourself right. You can't get yourself right. God bless you, Granny Green. God bless you. We love you. We love you. We thank God for you. We thank God for us being family. God bless you. And I believe in God to move for you and your family, Granny, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Supernatural help, God, in the name of Jesus. Supernatural help. Marissa, we thank God for continued healthy pregnancy for you and baby West, that every need is met. The stress load is lessening in the name of Jesus. All of us have stress, but some stress we don't need. The stress load is lessening in the name of Jesus. And I pray for an easy birth in the name of Jesus. I'm not sure if you're going to do something different with your birth, Marissa. I'm not sure if you're going to try and do like a home birth or go to one of those centers, you know, where you can have the baby. You know, it's not a hospital. I'm not sure. Or if you might be going to the hospital. But we're praying that everything will you know, go well for a healthy birth in the name of Jesus. Amen. And we thank God for the babies that are to come. Thank God for all that God is doing. God bless you, Tracy. Tracy from Virginia. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. We love you. We hope to see you soon. Hey, you going to Chi-Town soon, Trace? I believe it's in September. All right. So we're praying that you have a blessed time there. And Tracy, continue to let your light shine. Yeah, Tracy Miller. Continue to let your light shine. Continue to glean and to learn and to study your word. Because God is preparing you for something. I'm not sure if it's a message. I'm not sure if it's a time where you're going to be able to testify. I'm not sure what it is, Tracy Miller. But God is saying, take the word in now. Meditate on the word. Write it down. Repeat. Rehearse. And remember, like I said earlier, for some of y'all, for those of y'all who are on, you have to practice. Somebody be like, practice? I shouldn't have to practice serving God. Don't play with me. We have to practice learning how to trust God. The reason why we have to practice and we have to rehearse and we have to remind ourselves and we have to repeat is because our minds have been saturated with the world's way of seeing things ever since we was born. So when you become saved, that means now you got to turn around. You got to conform your word, your mindset to how God sees things, not how the world sees things. So yes, you have to practice. We have to practice. Many of us have to, on here, we have to practice not walking in our flesh. We have to practice not being angry, not being led by our emotions. We have to practice these things. But before you know it, it would become a natural part of who you are. Because you've been practicing, you've been repeating it, you've been rehearsing it, you've been reminding yourself, no. How many of you all sometimes you tell yourself, no, I don't respond like that. I don't react like that. I don't do that anymore. That is out of my character. I don't do that because I have the character of God. So I don't do that anymore. Is anybody besides me? And I remind myself. And it's not just because I'm a pastor. It's not because I'm a first lady. It's not because, you know, I'm a Christian. No, it's because of the relationship that I have with God, that I want to make sure that I'm representing him well. I told you all, even when we go through tough times, I want to do it well. I want to do it well. I don't want to embarrass God. And no, we're not perfect. No, we're not. But we need to be making progress. Amen. Amen. So yeah, I have to remind myself. Yeah. Yeah. God bless you, Teach. Yeah. God is what you teach. And y'all, I know, you know, many of us will say, Trace said, amen, I received. God bless you, Trace. Yeah, we love you. And Teach, many times, you know, we feel like, you know, I feel like I'm always under construction. I feel like I'm always under construction. You know, honestly, all of us are, a part of us is always under some type of construction. Because sometimes God will come in and he'd be like, you know what? That was good for 2010. That was good for 2015. That was good for 2024. That was good for renewed faith. But what I'm doing now, you know, I'm going to have to kind of sand some things away. I'm going to have to, you know, shore up here. I'm going to have to fix the foundation a little bit more. So God is always doing some construction on us. I myself, I welcome God telling me what I need to do and what I need to work on. Because it shows me that he's seeing me and it shows me that he cares enough about me to get myself together. Amen. 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 Yeah, Tamar said the pruning is ongoing. Amen. That's good. That's good, Mar. Okay. So yeah, y'all be encouraged. I truly, like I said, I thank y'all for being here with me on this morning. I pray that y'all are blessed. God bless you, Sister Norma. God bless you. We love you. We hope to see you on Sunday. Sunday, we're going to be at the Marriott, you all. We're not going to be at the Holiday Inn. We're going to be at the Marriott. So Norma, even if y'all can come, we would love to see you all, Sister Norma. And of course, we'd love to see all of you all. All right. Ignacio, you be encouraged. Son, you be encouraged. God is with you. Sometimes the enemy will make you feel like, you know, Lord, I felt like I was doing better. And I'm not saying that this is Ignacio. That, you know, sometimes the enemy, you know, he'll talk to us and be like, I felt like I was doing better. You know, when I was out doing stuff, I shouldn't have no business doing. No, don't let the enemy make a fool of you. How many of y'all have noticed that the Christians, we always get caught? Everybody else get along, get away. We always get caught. You had sex one time, you get the girl pregnant. I didn't even know what I was doing, God. Well, you did something right. No. You don't want to go back. I told you all, even if you're in a holding pattern, it seems like you're not making no progress. You ain't going nowhere. It seems like you are stuck in life. It seems like, what was the exact definition that I had? And I'm almost done, Mar. For the holding pattern. A state or period of no progress or change. I'm going to stand right here until God move. Okay, he ain't told me to move, I'm going to stand right here. And many of us, since God has not told you to move, that's what you do. You continue to stand. Stand strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Amen. So yeah, y'all be encouraged. Jamaica, you be encouraged. All right, Tisha, you be encouraged. PC, you be encouraged. God is with you. God is with you. Ayana, you be encouraged. God is with you. Like I said, Granny Green, Arissa, Sister Norma, Sister Meredith, Minister Tracy, y'all be encouraged. God is with you. God is with you. Tisha, God is with you. There's nothing too hard for the God that we serve. Minister Cynthia, God is with you. Tracy Miller, God is with you. Yes, God. Tisha said, I'm a little bonsai tree. Tisha said, Lafayette, I got one branch left. That's okay. That one branch is still blooming, though. Katricia, God is with you in the name of Jesus. Amen. There's only so far I can go back on my phone. Like I said, I thank God. Mother Lyons, God is with you. Sister Neely, God is with you. Amen. My girl, my pretty, I always call her pretty, Deborah Brown, First Lady Deborah Brown, always call her, because I just think she is just gorgeous. Well, she is gorgeous. The God is with you, sis. I told you, I think I saw Mother Lyons, God is with you. Deacon John, God is with you. God is with you. Deacon John, don't allow them people to be stressing you at work. I see you like turning red, you know, you light skinned. I see you turning red. Mm-mm. Don't be overcome by emotions. Don't be overcome by sudden fear. Don't be overcome by different situations. No. What it says, Proverbs 24:10, I'm not going to fall to pieces in the midst of a crisis. That's their crisis. That ain't yours. That ain't yours, Deacon John. Okay? So now I see, like I said, I see you turning red and like shaking your head. I'm not sure if it's a work, if it's something that you believe in God for, to move. Stand strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Continue to trust in him. Okay? Patricia Langham, God is with you. God is with you. I think Jamaica told you God is with you. I'm telling you again. God is with you and Jew. Ignacio and Jada. God is with you. God is with you. God bless you all. I pray that y'all be blessed on this day. For all the ones you may not have commented. Dick and Cliff, God is with you. All right. God bless. I think Emery, I saw Emery. Jeremiah, God is with you. Laura, Sister Maria, God is with you. DJ, my DJ. God is with you. I said, Neely, Tamar, God is with you, woman of God. God says, I see you. I see your diligence. I see you. I see you. I see you, Tamar. I see you. Tamar, I see a big eye. Like, his eye is on you. Not in a bad way, because you already know if you're cutting up. God already know how to call you on the carpet. No, he sees you. He sees you. You are the apple of his eye. Bree, God bless you. God is with you, Bree. I'm not sure if Nia was on here. God bless you, Nia. God is with you. For those of you all who will watch this later, God is with you in the name of Jesus. Alicia, Derek Jr., Rail, God is with you. God is with you. God is with you. Okay, Deacon John said today is Friday, no work. Amen. Well, yeah, Deacon John, like I said, I saw you red and like you was irritated. So I'm not sure if that could have been something that happened already, something that may happen. That's just that's how I saw you. And but even if, like I said, if something happened to pop up on today, no, Lord, the Lord said, give it to me. Even with paperwork, with the moves that you all are doing, give it to him in the name of Jesus. All right, Tisha, you're going to get in trouble. Amen. Thank you, Jamaica. Yes, God is with us. God is with us. I receive that in the name of Jesus. Sincerely, I received that. Oh, Toya. I remember Toya Slayer was on too. God is with you in the name of Jesus. All right. God bless all of you all. Okay. May the Lord bless you and protect you. This is number 6, 24 through 26. May the Lord bless you and protect you. May the Lord smile on you and be gracious to you. May the Lord show you his favor and give you his peace. Have a wonderful, beautiful, blessed day. We look forward to seeing y'all on Sunday, whether that be in person or we're able to meet. Deacon John said, no, you right on. Okay, amen. I know that's what I saw, Deacon John. Now don't let him get your red. You know, be calling people red bone from different southern states and stuff. No, Okay. Yeah. No, but we're looking forward to, y'all. We got the opportunity to be in person. Let's pack the place out. Okay. Let's get so packed out. We be looking at each other like, dang, can you move over? And for those of you all who can't be with us in person, make sure that you join us online. All right. God bless you all. Yeah. Dick and John, be encouraged and be strengthened in the Lord. Love you all. See y'all on Sunday. Oh, and Tuesday, prophetic encounter prayer. Tuesday, a prophetic encounter prayer, 5 o'clock a.m. with PC, Prophet Carter. It's going to be powerful in the name of Jesus. God is using him. God's got the word. And you never know. You need a word. You better get in prayer. And you never know. God can also have a prophetic word for you in the name of Jesus. All right. That's this coming Tuesday, 5 o'clock a.m. Don't miss it. Set your alarm now. Set your reminder now. All right. Love you all. God bless you. I said yes. Yeah, I said Mariel, DJ, Papa Leash. Yes. PC. All right. All right. God bless you all. And Robin Vita, God bless you. Deacon Robin's doing good, y'all. He back at work. God bless y'all.